In this presentation, we'll be looking at V-status mortality by age category, as requested by some viewers. This is somewhat of a continuation from my last video. The data we'll be using is from the UK's Office for National Statistics Deaths Involving Something by V-status. According to their notices, they will not be publishing this data anymore. I will be downloading their spreadsheet file on age standardised mortality rates. Specifically, we'll be looking at Table 2, Mortality Rates by V-status by Age Group, All-Cause Mortality, which includes falls, illness, cancer, everything. The columns we're interested in are V-status, Age Standardised Mortality, and Age Group, noting that the youngest age group is 18 to 39 year olds. There are no children in this data, which wasn't always the case. For example, in their report dated 24th of September 2021, they used to include people as young as 10 in a much broader category of 10 to 59-year-olds, but that's since gone by the wayside. Anyway, let's get started. Here's the youngest age category, 18 to 39-year-olds. As usual, let's begin with the unveed control group, shown in blue. A viewer asked to include confidence limits, so I'll include the 95% confidence interval, shown as thin blue lines, just for the control group. Let's add first dose recipients, who had their dose more than 21 days ago. If anything, they have slightly higher mortality than the control group. Remember, there could be other hidden factors. Also remember that these are all relatively young people, so naturally their mortality is going to be quite low anyway. For those who had a second dose at least 21 days ago, I would suggest their all-cause mortality is lower than the control group on average. Third dose individuals who had their dose at least 21 days ago also seem to have a lower mortality. But the surprising one, I suppose, is the fourth dose individuals who have a much higher mortality than the other groups at 6 or 7 or more times the mortality rate. Remembering there could be hidden variables at play here. Just one example, which is just speculation on my part. Young people who are likely to take a fourth dose might already be quite sick from some other cause, but as I said, that's just speculation and is not verifiable in this data. But from this view, you can see that young people in general have low overall mortality. For young people's mortality during the first 21 days after taking a dose, there just isn't that much data, but you can take a look at the overall mortality across all age groups during the first 21 days in my previous video, as shown on screen here. Okay, let's take a look at the 40 to 49 year olds, my age category. Just to make it easier for myself, I'll show all the data on the one graph, noting that all of these are all-cause mortality 21 days after taking a dose. First dose individuals have a significantly higher mortality than the control group. Those who took a second dose start out having less mortality than the control, but from 2022 onwards have very similar mortality. According to this data, third dose individuals have less mortality than the control, but again, people in their 40s who took a fourth dose have significantly higher mortality, especially in the first few months of the rollout. For people in their 50s, obviously the mortality rates are going to be higher as people get older. First dose recipients had a couple of months of low mortality in early 2021, but their mortality skyrocketed and stayed high ever since. As previously seen, second dose individuals start out having less mortality, but from 2022 onwards have very similar mortality to the control group. Again, three-dose individuals seem to have less mortality, whereas unsurprisingly by this stage, people who took four doses had significantly increased all-cause mortality, at least initially in this age group. It seems like there's a pattern of first and fourth-dose individuals having increased mortality rates. 60-year-olds, again, a significant increase in mortality generally due to age. Unsurprisingly, first-dose individuals have significantly higher mortality rates. Second dose started off well, but by 2022 had higher mortality than the control and stayed that way ever since. Three doses resulted in lower mortality at first, but by late 2022 had similar mortality rates as the control group. Fourth dose mortality, although not as pronounced as previous graphs, it still is pronounced, with the initial few months of data showing significant increases in all-cause mortality as compared to the control group. But after those first few months, the mortality rate seems to lower dramatically. 70-year-olds. As expected, mortality is much, much higher generally. All-cause mortality for those who took a single dose only was very high and stayed higher for the entire period. Again, second dose started off well, but showed significantly higher mortality as time progressed. Third dose also started off well, but by mid-2022 was trending above control group mortality. This is the first age group where the mortality rate of four-dose recipients has not been significantly different from that of the control group, very similar actually. Second to last category, 80 to 89-year-olds, keep an eye on the scale as the mortality rates for these higher age brackets have significantly increased. The control group's all-cause mortality rates average around 10,000 per 100,000. The mortality rate for first-dose recipients was extremely high early on. Almost one in every two people were dying, which steadily declined but stayed well above the control. As before, a similar pattern with two doses, starting off well but ending not so well. Three doses follows a similar pattern, started off well but didn't end very well. Fourth dose mortality for people in their 80s trended around or just below control group mortality. And our final group, the UK's most senior citizens, 90 years old and above. As you can see, first dose recipients had an extremely high mortality rate in the beginning, peaking at around 80% death rate in June 2021. Second dose recipients also had a similar peak, with a mortality rate over 70,000 per 100,000. Third dose recipients started off well, but by mid-2022 were significantly worse than the control group, with fourth dose individuals pretty much tracking the control group mortality. So basically, all-cause mortality for the control group remained pretty steady between 2021 and 2023, but that can't really be said for first and second dose. Anyway, that's the last ever report on V-status mortality coming out of the UK, at least for this period of history. I hope you enjoyed this presentation, but more importantly, I hope that society at least learns something from these last 2 years of observations.